Praise the Lord. Ratchet Knucklehead here, a.k.a. Brother Billy Jr. Brother says, we turn our Bibles to 1 John chapter 1. We'll be looking at verses 7 to 10. And it reads, but if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sin. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar and his word is not in us. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, to the hearing, to the admission, to the application, to the distribution of this great word, taken from the greatest book that man could ever possess. And my brothers, this is God's word. If you give God all the honor, all the glory, all the praise in the precious name of his son, our Lord and Savior, praise the Lord, amen. So the Apostle John writes this letter to the believers, and he we take this portion of this powerful letter that he writes in verse 7 of 1 John chapter 1, where it says, but if we walk in the light, so he told him to the believer, if we walk in the light, and this light is this revelation knowledge about how much God loves us, how much God has forgiven us of all our sins, past, present, and future, and how much God, we have eternal life with him. And walk in that revelation knowledge. If you walk in that light, as he is in the light, as Jesus Christ is in the light, he loves us, he forgives us all our sins, and he has everlasting life available for us. We have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sin. It's the blood of Jesus Christ that cleanses us from all sins. Sins that did in the past, did in the present, and sins that you're going to do in the future. If the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from all sin, then he goes on to say in verse 8, he says, if we say we have no sin, if we say we have no sin, if I say I have no sin, then he says, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. When somebody says they have no sin, they're deceived and the truth is not in them. Then we see in verse 9, it says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Now, I used to belong to a cult called the Church of Christ. And when somebody would get up to the pulpit and go to the people, and they would take 1 John chapter 1, verse 9, and they'll use that, and they'll beat your head over it. They'll say, hey, if you don't confess of your sins, if you don't confess of all your sins, he's not going to forgive you. So you better confess your sins. Every sin that you've done, you better, that's what the Bible says. Well, here's there's a problem with that. Because in Psalm chapter 130, verse 3, the psalmist makes a questions in that song where it says, if thou, and it says, if thou, this is talking to Jehovah God, if thou, Lord, capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D, the covenant-keeping God, if thou should markest iniquity. So the question is asked, if the Lord, the capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D, the covenant-keeping God, were to mark iniquity, keep an itemized account of all our sins, sins we did in words, thoughts, and deeds. If God were to make an itemized account of all our sins, the psalmist just says, oh Lord, who should stand? Who could stand with the perfect, Christ holy God making itemized account of your sins, sins that you did in your thoughts, your words, and your deeds? No one could stand. And so that's not what he's saying. The Apostle John was saying, confess your sins. You got to confess your sins. No, what he's saying is, if you confess your sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us of all our sins. Why is he faithful and just to forgive us of all our sins? It's because we confess our sins? No! The reason why is in verse 7. He is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness because of the blood of Jesus Christ, which cleanses us of all our sins. It's not our confessing of sins that gets us forgiveness of sins. It's the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, that cleanses us from all our sins. And so when we confess our sins, we don't confess our sins to be forgiven. We confess our sins because we are forgiven. And so he said, if we confess our sins because we know it's the blood of Jesus Christ that cleanses us from all sins, he is just and faithful to forgive us our sins based on the blood of Jesus Christ and to cleanse us from all of our unrighteousness. And watch this, verse 10. He says, if we say that we have not sinned, John's bringing another thing where he says in verse 8. If we say we have no sin, now I say, if we say we don't sin, we make him a liar. We make God a liar. We make our Lord and Savior Jesus a liar. And his word is not in us. Now watch what happens with that same train of thought that the Apostle John has. He says, my little children, thinking about the believers whose sins, all their sins are forgiven, past, present, and future, who has eternal life and who God loves them. With an everlasting love. These things write I unto you, that if ye sin, that ye sin not. Don't sin in words, thoughts, and deeds. This is the admonition. But watch this. And if any man sin in words, thoughts, and deeds. Watch this. We have an advocate with the Father. And who's that advocate of the Father? Jesus Christ, the righteous. You see, it doesn't say we have an accuser of the brethren. No, that's the enemy. And John spoke about that in Revelation. Apostle John spoke about that in Revelation chapter 12. He's the accuser of the brethren, but Jesus Christ is the advocate with the Father. And watch what verse 2. He is the propitiation for our sins, the believers. But then watch this. He takes it to another level, and not for ours only. But for the sins of the whole world. So if you were in the world, he's been a propitiation for your sins, for the sins of the believer, for the sins of the unbeliever. If you haven't had any time in the world, in the whole world, whether in the past, present, and future, he has been a propitiation for your sins. And as he is a propitiation for your sins, all your sins are forgiven. If all your sins are not forgiven, then you're not forgiven. The way that you're forgiven of your sins is all of your sins are forgiven. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, has cleansed us from all sins. So to be forgiven of your sins, you're forgiven of all your sins, past, present, and future. So when you confess to the Lord, you confess not to be forgiven, but you confess because you are forgiven. And watch this, what the Apostle John writes in verse 12 of this powerful letter. He says this in 1 John chapter 2, verse 12. I write unto you, little children, because your sins are forgiven. And when he's saying that your sins are forgiven, all your sins are forgiven. If all your sins aren't forgiven, then you're not forgiven. But because he says, because your sins are forgiven, is because all your sins are forgiven. For because your sins are forgiven you for his namesake. And what's that namesake? Our Lord. Our Savior, and soon to come King Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. All your sins are forgiven. Praise the Lord. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord face shine upon you. May the Lord lift up his countenance to you. May the Lord give you his peace. And I commend you all to God under the word of his grace, which is able to build you up an inheritance to those who are sanctified in the precious name of his Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. And unto him that is able to keep you from falling and present you faultless in the presence of his glory, both glory, majesty, dominion, power, both now and forevermore. Praise the Lord. Amen. If all your sins are forgiven, you're forgiven. And it's forgiven because of the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, and it cleanses us of all sins. Praise the Lord. God bless. Agape love.